Hello, Sci-Fish community, and welcome back to another World Tanks Console video. So, in this video, I'm going to be playing the T-72 Ural, which is the brand new premium tank for the Cold War. And it's the only premium tank for Era 2. So, if you're wondering, this is like the Era 2. What kind of matchmaking this tank gets? It's Era 2, and it's bottom tier matchmaking. So, it basically gets the same matchmaking as the T-62. And the M60. But don't let that stop you. Also, Era 2 tanks, Era 2 premium tanks especially, make a ton of silver. Even though I'm using a times 2 silver boost, you'll see how much I make in this battle. And even without the times 2 silver boost, it's massive. It probably beats out the Ragnarok and Hydra and like other tanks that make extremely amounts of silver. This is probably the brand new tank to make silver with. Unless they bring out other Era 2 premium tanks. But anyway. So, what do I have on this tank? For equipment wise, I have the advanced loader, advanced armor, and the traction system. I like the traction system so I can go faster. This tank's all about speed, so heck, let's make it faster. Now, my crew skills, there's only three. It's rapid loading, born leader, and supply conservation. And supply conservation is on my tanks because I'm using the smoke and hole patch, because those things take forever to cool down. It's 120 seconds, but with the supply conservation skill, is 102 seconds. So, T-72 Ural, rate of fire is 5.45, damage 550, it has a DPM of 3000. How fast does this tank go? It goes 64 to 18 reverse, power to weight ratio is 19.05. And gun depression is 6 degrees. So that's actually okay, but I can tell you that gun depression is not all the way around the tank. That's just at the front of the tank. If you like put your gun above your tracks, like barely above your tracks, you lose all 6 degrees of gun depression. You'll see during this, like right there, my gun just went up in the air. It only happened for a second because I moved my gun straight back over the front of my tank. So basically, your 6 degrees of gun depression is only in front of your tank. It's only at the front of the tank. So right now, I'm trying to look at the dispersion values of... I think we have those while moving tank. I think. Yeah. Accuracy during rotation is 1.75. And accuracy while moving is not a stat we currently have. So that's the stat they need to get some. So, yeah. So far, tank. Penetration. 372 millimeters of penetration, 420 on premium, and 125 on high explosive. It's premium, it's heat shield. So remember, there's a lot of space armor in Era 2. Especially on the Eastern Alliance. So heat rounds are not really going to take effect. Even though you have 372 millimeters of penetration. It's good penetration, don't get me wrong, but you still gotta aim for weak points. And I make that work in this video, because I only fired standard rounds in this video. And you'll see, like, even the, like, top Era tanks, like, Era 2 tanks that are, like, have, like, 3,000 hit points. The Eastern Alliance one, which is the T-72 AV, I believe? Oh, I have not learned the names of these tanks yet. Yeah, it's T-72 AV. You can still pin the lower plates of that tank. So, which is a really nice thing. You also can pin your own cupola, which is nice. I am planning to do, like, a showing weak point fear. Basically, I take a tank to team training, and I just shoot at it and show you all the weak points at. Show you the weak points where you can like pen it with what kind of rounds, with standard rounds of where you can pin it with premium ones. So yeah, basically I want to start doing those types of videos, especially with the Cold War videos, Cold War tanks, since there's no like websites to look that up on. There's no TCG, Armor Inspector, or anything like that. So yeah, video time. So we just got shot in the side, and there's a tank over there. I think it's M60. It's an M60 variant. I don't remember which one it was. And there's a T-72A over there. Hello, Mr. Guy? I don't know. Okay, so T-72A is the middle of the arrow, too. So, yeah, T-72A is supposed to be better than this tank. And also, you can also compare, like, the DPM. Is 3,000... DPM good at arrow 2? Well, how I look at it is basically this. So the hit points of arrow 2 range from, I think it's 2100 to 3000. So what tier does that remind you in World War 2? That reminds you of tier 10. There's tanks at tier 10 that have 3000 DPM and tanks that have 1400 hit points. But if you're not including lights or artillery, you have tanks earning from anywhere from 1,700 to 3,000. So, 3,000 DPM good in tier 10? Yes. Is 3,000 DPM good in this tank? This era? I think it is. I think it pretty much is. And I didn't even see this M60, like, off in the distance. I have no idea which one that is. I think that's the M60A3? Maybe? The only reason I seen him is because he fired off in the distance at one of my allies. I was like, hey, look, there's a shell. And I knew there was a tank out there somewhere. Just didn't know where it was. That shell led me into to find him. But if he was in like a bush or something, I would have never have found him. So this is where my gun depression gets me killed. This is where that... My 6 degrees, I didn't have 6 degrees of gun depression right there because my gun went over my track and I lost all 6 degrees of gun depression I had, which I was going to track that guy in place and I was going to track and pin him and my M60 beside me was going to kill him. So we probably could have killed that guy if I had the extra gun depression. Remember, I am using a times 2 silver boost, but I did make 375,000 silver. Did 7,000 damage, though. But anyway, if you liked this video, remember to like, comment, subscribe, also remember to subscribe to Facebook, because why would you not? And peace out, see ya!